everybody. We are in Parashat Pinchas. Everybody was waiting when is a portion of Pinchas is coming. Some tradition believe there is a healing power within portion of Pinchas. The reason for that is because many years ago, Rav Yehuda Tzvi Brandwein and Rabbi Yehuda Ashlag wrote the section of Evarim HaPlimiim, inner organ, that exists within the Zohar of the portion of Pinchas. And from that comes the tradition that there is a lot of healing power within this parasha. My opinion of this, that every portion of the Torah has a healing power, not just Pinchas, every healing power. But if that makes you happy and you believe Pinchas is the one, then Pinchas is the one. You know, there's a section in the Torah that's talking about Kel Narefanala, when Miriam gets sick, you know, Parashat Baalotcha. And this section, I believe there is more power of healing. But again, I'm not here to take tradition away from people. So let's focus on Pinchas and the portion, study some Torah about it, so, and we get to the next level. We know that in the 17th day of Tammuz, the tablet were broken. That's the golden calf. That's what happened in 17th of Tammuz, which is Sunday, 17th day of Tammuz, Monday is 18th of Tammuz, 18th of the day of Tammuz, and we have 3 weeks between 17th of Tammuz and 9th of Av. And we know in this time, it's considered more of opportunity time. I mean, if you are doing it correctly, use the right filter, as my son explained very well in the other video about this 3 weeks, then you can take advantage of this 3 weeks by getting the right energy that you need to get. But other than that, these 3 weeks can be challenging because in these 3 weeks, we have a lot of light, but no vessel. And when you place when you have a lot of light, no vessel, there is a judgment that takes place. And what is judgment? Judgment means that there is a lot of light, but it cannot contain into anything, into a container, which means there is no tzimtzum. I mean, those of you who study Kabbalah understand the whole concept of tzimtzum, contraction, restriction, whatever words you want to use, if it makes you understand the concept. I mean, the light was strong, the end soft, the endless light, and to reveal that light, you have to be metzamtzem. You have to be contracted, the light, so you can actually receive the blessing of the Creator, because the light comes from the Creator, and that light is all the blessing. But if you receive too much of the blessing, more than you can handle, then that create chaos. So for that reason, the tzimtzum take a place, so we will be able to receive the light according to our vessel. It's almost like when you look at the sun, and you cannot look at the sun. You either use sunglasses or something to cover your eyes, or you are squinting, you see your eyes, squinting your eyes like that, so you can actually see the light of the sun. What actually you're doing, metzamtzemet einav. You are contracting your eyes so you will be able to see the light of the sun. That's what's happening in these 3 weeks. I want to start with that to make sure everybody understands. You know, the light in these 3 weeks is strong. No wonder it's actually the summer as well. And those are Esau. Esau took over these 2 months. It said that Esau took the months of Tammuz Av. And when Yaakov took the months of Nisan Iyar Sivan, and then Yaakov negotiate for the last month called Elul. And that's why it's called Et. Et is Elul Tishrei. Negotiate for those months. But this is a different subject that we can talk at a different time. More important for me, before we start talking about Pinchas, to understand we're in the middle of the 3 weeks now. So that means a lot of light. Look for where you're doing squinting with your eyes. Where you're doing tzimtzumim so you can receive the light. So let's get going here. Pinchas. So what is the story? Let's start with the story. It says like that, last week portion, we end up with a section when Balak and Bilam trying to manipulate the people of Israel and kill them. They saw that they fell, so what they did? They sent women from Midianite, not only women, the daughter of the king, the king's daughter, to seduce sexually by using witchcraft and sex. So a lot of the people of the Israelites will die. The end result happened that as Zimri ben Salu and Kozvi Batsur is the daughter of the king. Zimri ben Salu is the head of the tribe of Shimon, Meklav. And as they make love, people drop dead, one after another, 24,000 people. Pinchas took Romach. Romach is a spear, a knife, a sword in his hand. And he killed both of them. Many miracles happened there, some say 10 miracles. And killing both of them was preventing the rest of the people of Israel from dying. That's what he did. He stopped the idea of death to take a place among the Israelites. And because of that, God announced him to be the high priest from his generation on. And God announced him to be very much respectful by all the people, which he wasn't before that. In a way, it's kind of contradict, because a Kohen or a high priest not allowed to kill, actually get fired. Pinchas was not a high priest, was not respect to become anything more than what he was, but after he did one act that's supposed to make him lose the keunah, lose the priesthood, he actually received the priesthood because of that action of killing, which is contradiction to everything. So for that reason, this portion has within it a lot of contradiction that doesn't make sense. I mean, this was happened Balak Bilam. So he killed, and then in portion of Pinchas, God is saying, for whatever he did, now I'm going to give him my covenant of peace. In the word covenant of peace, you have Vav that's split in the middle, no ink. If you look at the Torah, there is no ink in the middle. So you have to take a picture in the Torah to see it. You have Vav, and hopefully our team might be able to take a picture and put it there. You have the Vav split. And why the Vav split? And such a word called Shalom. Shalom means completion. Shalom means peace. Why you take it off? To show us that even the act is remove the ink from the letter Vav in the word Shalom, and by this creating Gimel Rishonot Vav Tachtonot, without going to details, even there, he still received the priesthood, because he was not looking to get the priesthood or recognition or validation. He was looking for completion of Am Israel, of the nation of Israel. He was looking to bring peace among the people. And because of that, even it damaged the word Shalom, Shlemut, completion, they get the Shalom. And this is an unbelievable, we can just talk just about that. So the rest of the portion is basically counting the people. All the holidays, all the Jewish holiday exist in the portion of Pinchas to show you the importance of his act and what can we as human beings can learn from that. What can we do about our life, you know? What can we do about our life so we can get into places where we do the right thing, even it seems that what we're doing is wrong for us as human beings, but we are bringing for everybody else to be okay. So, let's start. I'm starting from Kedushat HaLevi. Kedushat HaLevi is usually known, and the reason I read from Kedushat HaLevi, because Kedushat HaLevi will fit with this weak portion. Why? Because those of you who don't know Kedushat HaLevi, Rabbi Levi Yitzchak Berdichev, his mission in life, every Kabbalist, every righteous, every spiritual teacher has usually a style, a goal. And that style, work with that teacher, that rabbi for the rest of their life. The style of Rabbi Levi Yitzchak Berdichev was to see the good within every Israelite. He was looking for the good, looking for the good. Meaning, some people saw a person putting his tefillin, his talit, and praying while he's fixing his wagon. When you fix your wagon, you can take the tefillin off, the talit off, and fix, and then go back and put the tefillin again. So just to give you an example how we used to think, when people judge that person with tefillin and talit to fix the wagon, Rabbi Levi Yitzchak Berdichev used to say, what a beautiful Eid, what a beautiful Israelite. Even when he put the tefillin and talit, you know, and he does all this prayer, he fixes wagon, And while he's fixing the wagon, he still pray with the tefillin talit that God will help him to fix the wagon. He find the good within every mistake. So that's why I thought to start with Rabbi Levi Tzachak Berdichev, because to show how Pinchas used to think. So Rabbi Levi Tzachak Berdichev, the Kedushat HaLevi, say like that. Yivor Pinchas ben Elazar, v'yesh tadekdek tevat betocham. In the parasha, it say, v'yedaber Pinchas, Ishivet Ramadim al Israel Kanot Kinati Betocham. When he was zealous or jealous in the first verse of Pinchas, which is verse, actually Yud Aleph, the second verse, chapter 25, verse 11, it says Bekanot Kinati Betocham. When he was jealous within them. So what is within them? Ask Rabbi Levi Tzachak Berdichev. Ledekdek Tevat Betocham. Miutar. Of course, it's among the Israelite. Why you have to say בתוכם, עמוק די ישראל, צעי רבי לב אתכם בדיוק, מיותר. ועוד יש לדקדק, לפנחס לא עשה רק דבר אחד, שהיה מקנה, קנאת השם צבאות. זאת ברוך הוא שילם לו שני שכרים. פנחס, was just zealous or jealous, only for one thing. And God gave him two prizes. Why? And the two prizes he gave him, ברית שלום וברית כהונת עולם. He gave him the covenant of peace and the covenant of ultimate priesthood. והנה חזל, our sages say, in שיר השירים, מדרש רבה, פנחס זה אליהו, they say פנחס is actually Elisha the prophet. או בתוספות, in במבה מציאה, עמוד קוף ידלת, in a תוספות of במבה מציאה, it say, מביא בשם תנא דבי אליהו, שהם חולקים, there is a section from תנא, named דבי אליהו, that there is machlok, there is an argument. Mimi ba Eliyahu. Where is Elisha, the prophet, came from? Im Rachel, im Le'a. Did he come from Rachel? He came from Le'a. O ba Eliyahu, Elisha, the prophet himself, came to those sages. Amar lahem, shani mipnei banei shel Rachel. I am a descendant of Rachel. Venera, le'elu ve'elu divrei Elohim chayim. Of course, there is an argument. Because if we say Pinchas de Eliyahu, who is Pinchas? Which tribe he come from? Levi. Where Levi come from? Leah. So, is Leah or Rachel? We have argument. The clause that if we Adam chaz v'shalom bnei Adam shovrim avera v'koes, tachem v'mekanek kinat Hashem tzvaot, that chaz v'shalom borer dinim al Yisrael. And we have to say, if somebody see some of his brother and sister from the Israelite commit a crime, and he judge them, you're awakening the judgment on them. Pinchas. So, Zimri ben Salu, making a crime, making a sin, he judged, he went and killed. That's judgment here. How do we put it together? Pinchas, afal pi shekinet, kinat ha'shem tzvaot, afal pi ken lo haya borer aleihem dinim. How can that be? He's jealous for them, he finds what they do wrong, and he's not awakening judgment. How can that be? Rak chasadim, gedolim, mechaper al Yisrael. And it's in Masechet Sanhedrin, Amud Memdet, Memdalet. It say, Ribono Shel Olam, Alelu Iplu 24,000 Israel. And Pinchas say to God, are you going to kill 24,000 people from Israel for those two people who make love? He had the argument. So for that reason, God gave him the covenant of peace and the covenant that he was jealous to God. Obrit kunat olam. Why did he give him to become a Kohen? Michamat shaya betoch bnei Yisrael. V'lo yam efurad bem. What does that mean? Betocham, within them. Sometimes when you judge people, you become distance from them. There is two judgments. You judge people, you become distance, or you become, your judgment is actually to make them better. So you have to become part of them. Pinchas never lost the Betocham. He was part of Bnei Israel. Even if he was judging them, he wasn't judging them from a place of I'm above or I am better. He was Betocham. Betocham, within them. Vayam orer aleihem chasadim. And he wake mercy on them. Vechiper aleihem kemidat kohen. And because he was awakening the mercy, because he cared about them, because there is judgment and there is caring. It looked the same because when you judge people and you care for them, caring person, like a mother who cares for her son. Her son put poison into his mouth. She hit him on his hand. Take the poison out. Hit him on his mouth. Don't do it again. It's a judgment and caring. Caring. Kohen was like this. Pinchas was like that. For that reason, it's Midat HaKohen, which is Chesed. Mechaper al Bnei Yisrael. וזוהר רמז פסוק פנחס ולעזר, השיב את חמתי. What do you mean, השיב את חמתי? Okay? He brought the חמה. חמה mean sun. Or sun, like the sun in the sky. Or the heat, the negativity, the anger. He brought it back. מעל בישראל וקנות קנתי. ואף על פי קנה היה בתוכם. אמר רמז חסדים. So not only that he removed the judgment from the Israelite, he was בתוכם. He was part of them. He didn't feel he's better. He was one of them. Lachen amor lo. That's why I tell him, and he not tell him Brit Shalom. I'm giving him the covenant of peace v'chamat akina. V'tol ozaro acham v'chukram v'chapeh v'chisra k'al pish akina v'chapeh v'chisra. So why he get two crown of priesthood and crown of Shalom? Because the Shalom, because he was jealous for God. So they will not do the wrong thing. The Kuna, because he was cared for the people. Even he was doing job work, he didn't go and become like those fanatic people. In the name of God, let's kill everybody. No. He was saying, for the sake of people and for the sake of God, he worked on two levels at the same time. ויאמר עליהם חסדים. And he's awakening on them, the חסדים, the mercy. ובזה תבין, דאלו ואלו דברי אלוהים חיים. Now we understand the argument about is Eliyahu Navi come from Pinchas, from Rachel or from Leah? The Be'emet Eliyahu or Pinchas? Truly, Eliyahu is Pinchas. Then it's from Leah. But here it says come from Rachel. So how do we put it together? Kizel Hashon Natana Dev Eliyahu Bezuta. Ad Shabbat Elev Amar Lev Zeh Shani Eliyahu. I am the from Rachel. Why? Because Rachel represents judgment. Why Rachel represents judgment? Why? What does it say? It says in Bereshit, "Vatekane Rachel ba'achota." When Leah started giving birth, Rachel couldn't give birth. Rachel was jealous. Where is the jealousy come from Rachel? What it say about Pinchas? Kine le'elokav. He was jealous for his God. The word jealous also been used there. So what he did? He asked to be taken the energy of Rachel to use whatever he did, the miracle he did. זה שאני אליהו, שיש לו נשמה יתרה, שנקרא אליהו. אני מבני הבנייה של רחל. זוהי הנשמה ברחל, שאני אומר בה, ותקנה רחל. וגם רחל, ומלכות הוא הנוקם. So it's a tremendous secret of רבי לוי יצחק ברדיצ'וב, and always in Pinchas use the energy of רבי לוי יצחק ברדיצ'וב. But still, not clear all the way. Not clear all the way. So I was looking for a deeper meaning. And Hashem helped me to find something secret and tremendous from Maor Enayim. If you don't have this book, and you read Hebrew, you should get this book, Maor Enayim. Maor Enayim, written by Rabbi Mordechai of Chernobyl. And Rabbi Mordechai of Chernobyl, who's Kodesh Kodeshim, Tzaddik, Kabbalist, everything, everything. If something doesn't work in your life, always say, Rabbi Mordechai of Chernobyl, I want to talk to you about something, light a candle, and say, I need help. And you're going to have a miracle right away. Right away, miracle. And it says like this. We know that the Kohen is Chesed. Chesed means kindness, goodness. Pinchas is Makpid. Makpid means meticulous. And we know doing Rosh Hashanah, person should not be meticulous, doing Elul. Why? Because it's awakening the Gvurot. It's awakening the Dinim. It's awakening the judgment. So, when we look at Pinchas, right after he's awakening the meticulousness, then he becomes Kohen. Was he destined to become a high priest before? No, absolutely not. Only because of this act of meticulousness and gvura and harsh behavior, he became the Kohen Gadol. So let's read what Rabbi Mordechai of Chernobyl said. When a person has akpada, when a person has meticulousness, it's some type of gvura. Whenever you want something from above, it has to go through tzimtzumim. What is Tzimtzumim? You cannot receive directly from the Creator because it can kill you. It's almost like, you know, I will give you a concentrate juice that's supposed to be mixed with water. If I let you drink it like that, it's a problem. It's called merukaz in Hebrew, or rakaz. What is merukaz? Concentrate. You cannot have the concentrate ingredient and drink it. You have to dilute it with water. If you don't dilute it with water, you don't enjoy the drink. This act of making it diluted with water is called the Tzimtzum of the light. You cannot receive the light directly. You have to receive the light through Tzimtzumim, through filter. The same, as I said before, the light of the sun. What is the Tzimtzum that you receive from the light of the sun? The glasses that you wear. You have sunglasses, so you can enjoy a day on the beach or a day on the park. You can enjoy the light. Oh, now can that. Now even they can sell you computer glasses. You wear those yellow or blue. And because the light of the computer damaging you. Why? Because you need some type of Tzimtzum. When Bnei Israel התחילו לזנות, what happened? The Midianite start sending all the beautiful women to seduce the men of the Israelite. And they knew with the witchcraft and black magic and sex, usually those three ingredients can kill a nation. The purpose was to kill the Olam Israel, Chas v'Shalom. God forbid. So, what they've been awakening, when a person is about to go with another woman, or to have sex, or to make love, or to do something that gives you a pleasure for the body, where is that come from? Is it come from love, or come from hate? Well, it's come from love. It doesn't come from hate, it comes from, you have joy. I want to do that. Now, where is that energy and lust, L-U-S-T, come from? Where does that come from? Tell us, Rabbi Mordechai of Chernobyl, the love that exists from the Creator, how much the Creator loves us? Unconditional. That love that the Creator loves us is energy. Energy that we can call it light. Every time you want to do something that you love, you connect yourself to that energy of the Creator loving you. So, why do we have in Judaism things you're forbidden from doing and things you should be doing? Why is Judaism split to two? You should do everything you want if it makes you happy, if it makes you love. Well, those of you who study Kabbalah know that the universe went through Tzimtzumim. The universe went to contraction. Tzimtzum Aleph, Tzimtzum Bet, and others. What is Tzimtzum Aleph? Tzimtzum Aleph is when the vessel, the kli, in the Ein Sof, say, I don't want to receive all the love until I will be able to give the same amount of love. So it's Tzimtzum. So all the Ahava, all the love coming from the Ein Sof. If the act of love has not been done correctly, then that nourishment of love coming from the Creator have to go through a Tzimtzum, have to go through a contraction. And if that love going to contraction, what happened? It becomes less amount of love of what the Creator want to give you. What happened to the place where the love need to come? That place start to be fulfilled with judgment. So try to imagine a cup full with all the goodness. It's there. Once that goodness disappears, nothing stays empty. What takes place in that emptiness that was there in the cup? Judgment. When the Israelites saw all those women, seduction, like magic, it was some kind of happiness. Happiness like when a person about to commit a crime, to commit a sin. He feel like excited. Where does this excitement come from? Where does that excitement come from? I'm excited to enjoy. Well, you have to go back to understand what is the rules of the end self, of the endless. You cannot just enjoy. Even that needs to be restricted. Even that has to be contracted because it's Tzimtzum. So if you don't allow yourself to say no to yourself, what happened? Then that amount of love coming to the Creator, related to your capability to enjoy it, that love starts to disappear back to the Creator. And what happened instead? Judgment takes place. And from that, the 24,000 people start dying. They die from the judgment of the disappearance of the love that was supposed to be there. What Pinchas did? Did Pinchas stop the judgment? Nobody even been aware. Why did he stop? He stopped the sexual act between the head of the tribe of Shimon to Cosbi Batsu, to the daughter of the king. What is an act of making love? Making love. You hear what I'm saying? Making love. He stopped the love. Pinchas stopped the love between two people, stopped the making love, killed them. That forbidden love, or whatever you want to call it, nourishment that you cannot handle, that because of that it's awakening all the judgment and the death and the angel of death and the old people are dying, by stopping the love for the wrong thing, you also stop the judgment that comes with it. So, a person, when a person sin, with love. And then person asks themselves, that's what many people ask, what am I doing wrong? What am I doing? Why God have to put the kosher rules? Some people love shrimps. They love lobster. They love it. They love it. That awakening of love, that your incapability to do tzimtzum on yourself, to stop yourself from eating the shrimps, does that make you less loving the shrimps? No. You still love it. But by stopping the all nourishment of light, because light of love of God coming through shrimps too, coming through lobster, coming through cheating, coming through sexuality, coming through food, coming through drugs, coming through everything. But if you're not going to be able to say no to that, it's almost like you're saying the tzimtzum never take a place. And if the tzimtzum never take a place, tzimtzum in construction never take a place, that means that Mashiach is here. Is Mashiach here? Is the Messiah here? Is the temple here? No. So you have to play according to the rules of after the tzimtzum. What is the rules after the tzimtzum? What is the rules after the construction? After the restriction? After the vessel restricts itself? I cannot just do whatever I want. Not because God doesn't want you to. God actually wants you to do whatever you want. You're not capable to do whatever you want because you're awakening a love that's going from the end self. That type of light, you cannot handle. No wonder why Pinchas always fall on those 3 weeks. Why? To show us that those 3 weeks are full with light. And if you don't do the Tad'at Kuzom Atzpat, all those meditation, you cannot receive the all light that you meant to be receiving. I found this Pirush of Rabbi Mordechai Chernobyl to be one of my favorite now of understanding what exactly took place. But as every week, you know, we also have to read the Zohar. But just to add, he become Kohen. What is Kohen? High priest. What is the high priest? Midah, the attribute of Kohen, the high priest, unconditional love to the people of Israel. That's what a Kohen does. In a way, he killed the love for the wrong reason, so they will be able to connect to the right thing. Now we know that the Zohar, before getting to the Zohar, ask a good question. What is it, why is it say, Pinchas ben Elazar ben Aaron HaKohen? It says the word ben twice. It's to show you that the two children of Aaron that die in a different event, Nadav and Avihu, enter his body. Enter his body. That's what the tradition say, Pinchas Eliyahu. That's what they say, Pinchas is Elisha the prophet. Why is saying Elisha the prophet? If you remember, when Elisha was about to receive the gift from Eliyahu Navi, Eliyahu Navi, Elisha the prophet, was the number one, prophet, and his successor was Elisha. And when he asked Elisha, what do you want? Elisha answered, Yina pishnayim beruchecha alai. May you have twice of what you have to my soul. But the commentary explained, Na is Nun Aleph, Nadav, and Avihu. So Nadav and Avihu enter Pinchas, and that's why it says Ben Elazar Ben Aaron HaKohen. Now we're going to Zohar Pinchas 156. It's written, 156 in Sulam. It's written, Amar Rabbi Yitzchak, Mikra ze kacha ya tzarich likatev. Rabbi Yitzchak has an issue with the section in the Torah. V'shem Yisrael asher ika Pinchas. It was supposed to say the name of the person that Pinchas was killed. He killed him. What is it the Torah said? Amuke asher uka. The one who was killed, that was killed. It doesn't even relate it to Pinchas. It related like this person died by himself. Why, said the Zohar? Why, said Rabbi Yitzchak? In verse 156, good question. Not even mentioned. Pinchas killed him. Ela, any answer, in the name of Rabbi Lazar, the son of Rabbi Shimon. Kevan, שהקדוש ברוך הוא העלה את פנחס לכהן גדול. Because God already decided that פנחס will be a high priest, לא רצה להזכיר את פנחס בהריגת אדם. God didn't want to mention him connected and related to killing a person. כי אינו יפה לכהן גדול. It's not nice to speak like this on a high priest that he killed people. מטרם שאלה הוא לכהן גדול. הזכור ואמר, ביר פנחס ויקח רומח. וכל שניהם, כיוון שאלה הוא לכהן גדול. So before that, before God announced him as כהן, high priest, he was mentioning him with the knife, with the sword, with the spear, with the killing. Everything was mentioned. Last week, Pasha. That was belonged to Balak. But when it belonged to Pinchas, who he is, what his title? Oh, it's Kohen Gadol. You cannot mention killing with him. Kino Rawilo. It's not nice. Pinchas alav kufot ha-kadosh b'chu. And God has mercy on him. She Kohen Gadol eno ra'u le'yot niskar b'ariga. Because the Kohen, the high priest, not supposed to be mentioned with killing. And also it doesn't mention the woman who killed her. He just say Araga. I found that very, very powerful. And another section is section 460 in the Sulam. 460. It say, Pinchas amad lefnei din hachazak shel Yitzchak. Pinchas has to deal with some judgment from Isaac, because we know Isaac is gvura, and he had to stop the left column, which is gvura. That's why his letter, that additionally to Pinchas, was Yud, small Yud. Where does the Yud come from? Yitzchak. Why? Because if you add Yud to Pinchas, it becomes Gematria Yitzchak. So it shows you that he was preventing that Gvurot coming from Yitzchak. Vayamot Pinchas. Yudu Pinchas im Yud. Amad bapritza. Fnei adin shel Yitzchak. Kedei lagen al Yisrael. Vze vaze vachishmol klova shel Pinchas vegematria Yitzchak. That's why Pinchas with Yud, the moral revalue Yitzchak. Vim tomer. I'm skipping now to 462. Pinchas is Yitzchak. Pinchas is actually Isaac said this all. She Pinchas amad v'dan din shel Zimri v'kezvi. Because Pinchas was busy with the judgment of Zimri and Kozvi. Mitlabesh v'gvura chazaka. And how he did that? He received the harsh judgment coming from the left column. We call it Yitzchak. Mishum ma'aseh hazeh zachah Pinchas liyimin. And because he was able to conquer that left column energy, he got the merit of the right column. Now he zachah lekuna shechesed. Because he would become a high priest, which is totally chesed. He is included the left and the right. Eshivet chamati. What is a sheaf? A sheaf mean he returned my anger. Maui sheaf et chamati. Say the Zohar, what exactly the anger we talking about when we talk about God? Umeshiv, the Zohar said, Elohim gimim unim shogenom. Said there is three ministers in charge of hell. We call them bashchit, debager, af, anger, vechema, harsh anger or rage. Ki Pilchas ra oto achema. Pilchas saw the chema. That angel come from hell. That has to do with anger. That's why people get angry. Have to be careful. You're awakening those three angels of anger coming from hell. Mitpashet ve'nimshach mitzad Yitzchak. It's coming from Gvura, come from left column. Ma'asa, what he did? He tlabesh ma'madragat Yitzchak. He took and he dressed with the clothing of Isaac, not physical clothing, the energy of Yitzchak, shu ha'shoresh shel chema. Because what's the roots of anger in the wrong way? The left column, the judgment energy. Ma'azachat b'oto chema, k'vi shokhez b'chavero, shuv l'achro. So, from a left column point of view, he can hold the chema, he can hold that anger and put him back where it belongs. Tell us the Zohar, tell us Rabbi Yehuda Ashlag. What is chema? It's judgment of the male, which is those judgment coming from the left column, which is Isaac. And because Israel, it wasn't just sex, it was idol worshipping, which is left column energy from left, from above to below, the awakening that negative angel. That's why he dressed himself with that energy of left column, which is the roots of chema, and he held it and he pushed it away. And for that reason, say the Zohar in verse 463, he didn't say remove the anger, he said retain the anger. What is the difference between remove and return? He wasn't canceled. Silekota, prinat panim bilvad. He removed it, it will not be in the face, it will be achoraim, be in the back. Because the chema is the harsh judgment that coming from the light of wisdom. The light of wisdom is not bad. It's just if you don't have the right vessel, it can hurt you. So what he did, he suppressed that energy. He covered that energy. It will not be just light of wisdom, because we need the light of wisdom. Because the light of wisdom, that chema, is basically almost like burning the negativity, the resha'im, the negative people to be removed. You want your enemy to leave you alone. You want your misery to go away. You want the one who tried to hurt you not to come. What do? You're awakening enough light to burn them. So you need the left column energy. You just need the left column energy to be contained. Don't be all over the place like a wire with electricity that is just going crazy. Don't want that to happen. So he put the chema where it belonged. That's what he did. And then, what exactly happened? What was the process? So I'm continuing to 664 in the Zohar. Shuel katu vayar Pilchas. It say that Pilchas saw. Vaykach romach. Then he took spear. Mara. What did he saw? All of our soul were there. We didn't see. He saw. What did he see? Umishuv ra'a mem. He saw the letter mem. The letter mem will start flying in the sky. You see in the sky, you see mem. That letter is the sign of the angel of death. A mem, the way it operates in the non-physical universe, it first has to be operate in energy universe. But is the energy have clothing too? Yeah, the clothing of the energy is Hebrew letters. So he saw the letter mem, so whoa, the letter mem now looking for the vav and taf. Vav and Taf together, Mem, Vav, Taf together, is Mavet, death. Ma'asa Pilchas, Amit Labesh Bitzchak, we say before, he dressed like Isaac, meaning Gvura. Lakachota ot Mem, he took the letter from the sky, Mem, Chatafota, he kidnapped, the word that the Zohar used, he kidnapped the letter Mem. Who did he kidnap the letter Bem from? Mimalach HaMavet, from the angel of death. V'chibra imo, and he let the letter Bem become his. כיוון שראה מלאך המוות שפלחס חטף אותה מהם אמו, מיד חזר לאחור. When he saw פלחס stole the letter Bem, the angel of death say, whoa, this guy not fighting me with fist. This guy doesn't even fight me with kind of words. He fight me with consciousness, and he know how to combine the letter. He took the Mem, and I cannot do a lot. 665 זוהר. שואל, מהו הטעם של הדברים? Nice. He stole the Mem. What does that mean? משום שפלחס קינא בליבו. Because he was jealous, all jealous. נתלבש ביצחק. He was dressing with יצחק. וניתן לה להיות בחשבון רש חט. If you take the word יצחק, let's do it together. Okay? יצחק is 100 of an 8. 108 with 10, what is it? 118 plus 90. What is it? 208. What is it? Reshchet, right? Reshchet. Shekach ole shmo, Reshchet. And if you put Pinchas with Yud, it's also Reshchet. Both of them are 208. But focus on the letter Resh and Chet. He stole the letter Mem from Malach HaMavet. What do you have now? Romach. You have the Romach, you have the spear. Now you know what he... Vayikach Romach biyado. What if he cannot find Romach? What if he cannot find Spear? Oh, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? It was a letter consciousness, guys. Resh el Chet from Yitzchak. Mem from the angel of death. Put it together. Get Romach. That's our way. Ki ha-mem nitchabra im ha-gimatria Resh Chet, shebashmo, ne'asa tzirof Romach. Vayikach Romach v'yodo. Mishom shirot men, hayta siban ha-rishon la-adam ha-rishon, livnot mavet al-olam. How do we know that the letter Mem relate to death, from the angel of death, because we know it from Adam. משום שעוד זו אף על ראשו של אדם בשעה שכתוב ותיקח מפריו. What does it say? It say that חווה, Eve, when she seduced her husband, it says ותיקח מפריו. She took from the fruit of the tree of knowledge. And she took from the fruit. מפריו. הוא אותיות מם, פריו. What fruit she took? She took the fruit of the letter מם. Mi perio, from the fruit. From in Hebrew is Mem. So she took the fruit of the Mem. Hayta metzapah la'otiyot vav v'taf. But the letter Mem is alone. Without vav and taf, you don't have mavet, you don't have death. Bizman shekatuv, vatochal, vatiten, vatipakahna. If you, it's a vatikach, vav taf, letter vav taf. Vatochal, another letter vav taf. Then it's a vatiten, then she gives to her husband the fruit. Vavtav. Vatipakachna, and her eyes was open. Again, Vavtav. So we have Vavtav, Vavtav, Vavtav. All this looking for the letter Mem, from Mipirio, you have Mavet. As divna amavet ala olam. Beken Pilchas. So when Pilchas היה רואה אתה עוד Mem, שאתה אף על ראשם, הוא ניצור את הלטר Mem, he said, whoa, that's the same Mem from Adam and Eve. ואיך ראה אותה? רצו עד Mem פתוחה מלא אדם. תראה זה זור, he saw the Mem, full with blood. כיוון שראה אותה אמר, הרי ועדיי הוא סימן של מלאך המוות, he said, the angel of death is coming here. מיין חטפה, he kidnapped the letter, he said the name of God, המפורש, יוד כבבקי, מילו יודין, והוריד אותה האות אצלו. And he brought it with him, and he have the רש חט, and מם רומח. And that's why he said he was jealous. What do you mean jealous? Because he was ready to die for that cause. He was among the people. Among them. Betocham. It's a different perush. From Rabbi Levitz. What is Betocham? Nechnas betoch kama amonim, betoch kama gdolim. He was among all the people. Masar atzmo lemita b'shvilam. He was ready to die. Kedela atzilam. So he can send them for the angel of death. Betocham, tell us the Zohar, but there is another secret, tell the Zohar. Betocham, among them, rutiyot betoch Mem. He went betoch amem, within the mem. Ki betoch mem aita ota kina shekine. He was only busy with the letter mem. That it will not be part of the death. My friend, this portion, as you can see, as we did it, prevention of death. Are we cutting corners? Are we cheating a little bit when we do Pirchas and we're kind of getting all the benefit? Well, if you know about it, you're lucky. And if you know now why you're doing Pirchas, why, no matter where you are, you want to be with us in Pirchas, no matter where you are, no matter where, if you hear this lecture, make a ticket, fly. I don't know where we're going to be. There's rumors we're going to do Shabbat in the valley, maybe here, I don't know. Depends on if it will be a lot of people. Of course, we have to organize it differently. But this is to prevent death. By using this parsha, by using this knowledge, by using this information, of course, you remove all the disease, that the cause of all disease to cause death. Now, the question is, why all the chagim, why all the holidays in this portion? All the holidays that you read is in this portion. Because, again, according to my poor opinion, I think there is a lesson here for all of us. Everybody looking to do the right thing. There's two women who do the wrong thing and become, in the eyes of God, as kings and queen. One of them is Yael with Sisra. She seduced sexually Sisra. Then she killed him, and that's how she saved her people. And second is Pirchas, or first I should say Pirchas. And the idea is to make us understand that the whole holidays, the whole chagim that we are celebrating, is truly to bring us to a place, not just to look what's right, what's wrong, to see that our mission is right. Because there is a big difference between what you want to what's your intention of wanting it. If what you want is only to satisfy yourself, then of course it's wrong. But if what you want is to satisfy society, then what you want has to be right. And because of that, I have to say this is a tremendous avana. And tremendous avana in the Torah, why the holidays? What is Pesach all about? What is Rosh Hashanah that coming soon is about? What is Yom Kippur? What is Sukkot? It's to train us that we will always be in the places where we do the right thing, but not for us. We do the right thing so society and the community and the global community will be a better place to be. Thank you, everybody, and have a wonderful, wonderful week.